लेट स्पीक अप फॉर SSC रेलवेज. क्वेश्चन नंबर 42 इज फ्रॉम सिविल सर्विस एग्जामिनेशन कंडक्टेड बाई UPSC. द सब्जेक्ट इज जनरल साइंस एंड द सोल्यूशन इज एट लास्ट ऑफ दिस वीडियो. द क्वेश्चन गोज एज इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ग्रुप्स आर ऑल द फोर कंट्रीज मेंबर्स ऑफ G20. G20 or Group of 20 is a group which consists of 19 individual countries who are the major economies of the world plus the European Union. So it's important to note that is a group of 19 individual countries, not 20, plus the European Union. G20 was founded on 26th of September 1999. The membership of countries is represented by the head of the state, for example, the prime minister or the president of the country, and also by the head of the central bank and the head of finances or the finance minister. But the European Union is represented by the head of the European Commission and by the head of the European Central Bank. G20 was formed with the aim to discuss policy pertaining to the promotions of international financial stability. So the main initial focus was on the promotion of international financial stability. It's important to note that the first summit was held in November 2008. There's some elaboration of the aim. So the aim is to bring together systematically important industrialized and developing economies to discuss the key issues in the global economy. And it's important to note again that since 2008, finance ministers and foreign ministers have periodically conferred at summits. So since the first summit, the finance minister and the foreign ministers have conferred. In the year 2009 and in the year 2010, the summits were held twice, and the Canadian finance minister Paul Martin was chosen as the first chairman, and the German finance minister Hans Eichel hosted the inaugural meeting. So moving forward to the next slide, the summit for year 2018 was held at Argentina, 2019 at Osaka, Japan. The 15th summit or the summit for the year 2020 is to be conducted at Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. The head of states will meet between 21st and 22nd November. The 16th summit is to be held in Bari, Italy. And the 17th summit for the year 2022 is to be held in New Delhi, India. So the member nations are divided into 5 groups, with group number 3 having only 3 members and rest all having 4 members each. Also, nations from the same region are placed in the same group except group 1 and group 2. That is, group 3, 4 and 5 have nations from the same region. All the countries are eligible to take over the G20 presidency when it is the group turns. So G20 presidency is distributed group wise and each group members contest for the presidency. That is, states within the relevant groups need to negotiate for presidency. Each year a different G20 member country assumes the presidency. That is, the presidency is temporary and the presidency starts from 1st of December until 30th of November, and this system of rotation of chair has been in place since the year 2010, when South Korea held the G20 chair, which is in group 5. The presidency of G20 is supported by Troika, which is made up of the current, the immediate past and the next host country. So the countries in group 1 are Australia, Canada, Saudi Arabia and the United States. In group 2, we have India, Russia, South Africa and Turkey. In group 3, we have Argentina, Brazil and Mexico, only 3 members. In group 4, we have France, Germany, Italy and the UK. In the group 5, we have China, Indonesia, Japan and South Korea. I have also come up with a mnemonic for you to easily remember the names of the countries in G20 group. So here is a mnemonic for you to easily remember the names of the countries. Say Jerome and say Junks can find it turn in urban Australia, where SA stands for Saudi Arabia, GE for Germany, J for Japan, ERO for European Union, ME for Mexico, SA for South Africa, GE is repeated, CH for China, UNK for United Kingdom, S for SK, SK for South Korea, CAN for Canada, F for France, I and D for Indonesia, IT for Italy, TU for Turkey, RN has no significance, IN for India, U for USA, R for Russia, B for Brazil, AN for Argentina and Australia. So total of 19 individual countries and one European and the European Union. Going to the last slide. So here's a list of permanent guest invitees for in G20 conferences. See, G20 conferences are not only attended by the members by the member countries and the European Union, but we have some permanent guest invitees like the African Union, the Association of Southeast Asian Nation, or the ASEAN, the Financial Stability Board, International Labour Organization, International Monetary Fund, Spain, WTO, World Bank, the United Nations, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, and New Partnership for Africa's Development. So they're allowed to keep their points in a discussion. G20 has expanded their agenda. So their agenda includes financial focus, as we discussed in our first slide. Then we have some inclusive growth agendas, which include migration, digitization, employment, healthcare, economic empowerment of women, and development aid. We also have some interrelated themes between the countries, for example, the national security. So this was all about G20. Thank you. This video will be always here. Come back to watch.